I was driving it away. I found the van blissful. I was grateful. I would love to see it enacted again and extended if possible. I work at home, I write at home, and I think at home. We are at work here, right now. We are accomplishing things. We have two important elements here at work to foster our ability to compose our thoughts, order our ideas, and make our points clear for all, light and quiet. I'm not being paid for composing my thoughts right now, but during the day I am. And I'm not the only one. Writers, composers, journalists, designers, artists, musicians, mothers of napping children, and school children who have homework to do after school are all affected by leaflets. Approximately 720 minutes of my week each week are affected by the deafening sound of not one, but often multiple leaflets, which I find unnecessary. They're sometimes very small, including my own postage stamp size of yellow.
Yeah, me 7 Tower Drive. I agree with the previous speaker. The van had a very positive quality, a positive impact on our quality of life. I also work from home and do websites. And I would like to suggest two things going forward. First of all, I agree that the van should be repeated, if not extended. On Sunday, there's a year-long ban on leaf blowers until 11 o'clock. I would like to see this extended to Saturday. Those of us who, like my wife, work in the city and work very long hours, and Saturday morning as well as Sunday morning is really the only time to relax in a quiet environment. And on Saturday, leaf blowers are legal starting at 7 a.m., which I think is too early. It would be great if, like Sunday, they could be banned until 11. The other thing I'd like to suggest is some training for the people who use the leaf blowers. And observing them, I see that a lot of them point the blowers right at the ground, straight at the ground, and go very slowly back and forth. They don't know what they're doing, I don't know what they think they're doing. But they are getting to blowing up a lot of the dust and the pesticides and chemicals that we put on our lawns.
I'm the executive director of the New Jersey Landscape Contractors Association. We have about 550 member companies, which translates into about 10,000 landscape contractors that we represent. The goal of our association is to educate, help professionalize, and to protect our members. We don't oversee all the landscape contractors in the state, but we try to influence them as much as possible. With the blower ban, with the pilot program, our biggest concern is the fact that it is specific to landscape contractors. So I'm speaking tonight on the subject of protecting our members. We've done research as well. We've discussed this at board meetings. And the reality is that Maplewood is the only town that is specifically targeting landscape contractors. Last time we were here, we spoke about bans in California, and we've downloaded what the bans are. Laguna Beach, California, the use of electrical or gasoline power blowers, commonly used by gardeners and other persons for cleaning lawns, yards, drivers, etc., is prohibited at any time within city limits. It's for everybody. Claremont, internal combustion engine, power leaf blowers shall be prohibited after March 1991, so we're pretty far back. Beverly Hills, same thing, gasoline engines to blow dirt leaves and other WR sidewalks is prohibited. And the majority of these are under the noise disturbance statute. They're not, they go along with other things that make noise. If we look at Los Altos, they have loudspeakers, animals and birds, barking dogs. They're pretty serious out there. They have meows and squawks as noises, but it's under the noise ban. Los Angeles, same thing. No gas powered blowers shall be used within 500 feet of a residence at any time. I'm not sure what the thinking is there. Malibu, California, same thing. It's a noise ordinance, and it's not specific. If you look at, and I'm going to keep to my time, if you look at the township of Maplewood, the resolution is prohibiting the use of leaf blowers by commercial lawn maintenance businesses. It's not for other businesses, it's not for tree companies, it's not for asphalt companies that use blowers, it's not for companies that strike parking lots, it's not for builders, it's only specifically for commercial landscape contractors, and that is basically an industry profile that we're being discriminated against. We're not going to say that the blowers don't make noise, they absolutely do. They are allowed. I agree that there should be hours that they should be able to be used. I think using them on Sundays should be prohibited in every single town. Saturdays, you know, every as well, or during the week, 7 o'clock is too early. There's other things that contractors can do. So we want to come up with solutions. I've worked with on Claire when we were trying to come up with their solution. But again, they don't discriminate against landscape contractors. They have specific times that of the year, specific times of the day that blowers can be used, but it's across the board. So we feel that we'd be more than happy to work with you to come up with a solution, but if it's going to be a ban on blowers, it needs to be a ban across the board, homeowners, everybody. If it's not going to be a ban, then obviously there's less for us to worry about. So I have to say that. So thank you.
As agent, and I am the legislative, at the end time, attorney. I'm not representing the New Jersey Landscape Contractors Association, but I am an attorney, but I'm not representing them. But I'm their legislative chairperson. So in analyzing the ordinance, and doing, I think my executive director, Jody, just did an excellent job outlining, you know, many of the issues. But when you think of it, I just can't understand how it doesn't violate the Equal Protection Clause of the U.S. Constitution. It's discriminatory, and if you apply even the lowest level rational basis analysis, there's no rational basis to discriminate against children that are going to be. What about the children that are living next to the handyman that uses the blower all the time? It's also there's a health hazard, and these sucking up the emissions in a particular manner for children next to a handyman that is using a blower, that's not discriminatory? I just don't get it. What about the guy that's using that, and the children, those kids have to live next to that all the time, and they're sucking it in, but the other children don't. Doesn't make sense.
Your point that everybody should be covered by the ban.
I'm going to leave the, you know, I'm going to leave to our executive director the position I'm going to approve, but I just needed to emphasize that one extra point. I just don't understand that how you could selectively say for landscape, you know, lawn maintenance companies why they can use it. If it really is a health hazard, I can't see why I'm going to go across the board.
Okay, just since you're looking at me saying that.
No, but
it's fine. The discussion back in the spring about this issue, some members of the township committee, and since it was a pilot and not an ordinance, it's just a resolution for the summer, that some members of the township committee didn't feel right keeping our residents from using them. I personally would like them all to be allowed for the reasons you state. Other contractors, such as a gutter person or something, they're typically not blowing the gutters every week on a certain day. They're just doing it once and gone. So a handyman, same thing. So I think there was, because the landscapers use them on a daily basis, on rotating week after week after week, that was the reason that the pilot covered that. So I don't want to speak for the rest of the town, but that was my...
Right, okay. And one more minor point, or, you know, if it's this noise issue, if you hear like a noise, you know, we might be able to deal with that. I just think there would be better ways to handle things. But my main point was, really, if you have have children next to a handy person that's always using a blower, it's just common sense, it's going to impact those children, and you have to do it across the board.
Like as residents, people, I wasn't very thrilled. as a lawyer, I felt like it was tortious interference with our contract because we were bound to an annual contract with our landscaper. So I had like breathing problems, allergies and whatnot, and some of what the surgeons and what they do, and also using their blowers to keep things off and around that grow over my porch. We have a very large home and a very large bit of land. That was one.
Right, just to maintain, you know, keeping the dust and the pollen off of our porches and our decks is what they use it for. And like you said, it kind of went against the contract that we'd already previously signed with our landscape company to be able to provide these duties, so that they were not be able to provide those duties within the contract that we signed with them over the months that we instituted this pilot program. We also, I noticed that the landscapers, they're going to find a way to do the duties that they want to do without, you know, using hand tools. So in a sense, from a noise situation, I didn't hear the noise change because I noticed that most of the landscapers were using their lawnmowers as their blowers instead of the actual blowers themselves. And driving it around the driveway to get all the grass clippings and the dust and the dirt off the driveway instead of using their blower to do so. So there's still a motor running, it's a four-cycle motor instead of a two-cycle motor, so I understand there's a little bit of noise pitch difference, but not a loudness difference. And so the situation of noise is not being curtailed by just banning the blowers.